بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today the question is why read the Quran with tajweed, and it's a very good question. Now first of all, before we go into this question, we kind of need to understand just what tajweed is. Now the word tajweed comes from the root word jawada. Okay, comes from the root word jawada, and it means, it's a means to improve, it's a means of perfection, proficiency, to achieve proficiency. And obviously in practicality terms, this is referring to reading the Quran to the best of your ability with the correct rulings of tajweed. Now, as we know, as Muslims, Islam teaches that if you are to do something, then you are to do it to the best of your ability. So when it comes to reciting the Quran, we know that this is the best of speech. These are the best of words, because the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is perfect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's words are perfect, and so they deserve perfection, and they deserve to be articulated and to be spoken in a beautiful manner. Now the Quran is different to any other book. The Quran is not like a newspaper. It's not like a magazine where you sit there and you read it, blah 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 blah. It's not like that. It's not even like a poem. The Quran is different, and it is to be recited, not just to be read, but to be recited with its tajweed. The Quran and tajweed are not two separate things. The Quran and tajweed are one. They are to be put together. They are together. The Quran is with along with its tajweed. They are to be read like this. This is the way the Quran is meant to be read. That is why it's different from any other book. And we know this because we know that we should be reciting it like this, because from the famous Jazariya poem, when Muhammad ibn Jazari himself, he says, وَالْأَخْذُ بِالتَّجْوِيدِ حَتْمٌ لَازِمُ مَنْ لَمْ يُجَوِّدِ الْقُرْآنَ آثِمُ. So he says, and applying tajweed is an issue of absolute necessity. Whoever does not, then a sinner he is. Now I want to very, very much stress here that this is not referring to the person who is struggling to recite the Quran properly, but he's still making mistakes. And we know this because of the hadith in Sahih Muslim, where Aisha radiallahu anha, she narrated that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, الماهرُ بالقرآن مع السفرة الكرام البررة والذي يقرأ القرآن ويتتعتع فيه وهو عليه شاق له أجران. الله. Beautiful, beautiful hadith, very famous hadith you may have heard of before, whereby the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the one who recites the Quran while he is proficient in its recitation will be with the honorable and obedient scribes. Of course, this is referring to the angels. And the one who recites the Quran while it is difficult for him to recite will have double the reward. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encouraging you. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encouraging the person who is struggling, encouraging the person who is finding it hard, who is finding it hard, who is trying hard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them double the reward. Now, tajweed is not something which is additional. It's not something where you can, it's like an extra, you can choose to opt out. Tajweed is to the utmost importance when it comes to reciting the Quran. And the reason for that is because clarity is very important. The slightest of changes in the Quran will make the biggest of differences. For example, the word qalb and the word kalb. Qalb meaning heart and kalb meaning a dog. Okay? And if we just see this in, of course, it's just a change of one letter, qaf and kaf. But if we look at this in a practical example from an ayah from the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالَ أَوَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ. He says to Ibrahim, oh Ibrahim, do you not believe? قَالَ بَلَى وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي. He said, بَلَى. Yes, I do, of course. However, I just want to make this strong, want to make this tranquil and firm within my heart. If we change this now and we say, قَالَ بَلَى وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي. He says, yes, I do believe. However, I want to make this strong and firm in my dog. This is when things become highly problematic, and this is not something which we want to fall into. And we're going to start changing the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is something we definitely do not want to do. Now, some people think that it's being over the top. Tajweed, you know, it's too much, it's rigorous. But because of these rigorous methods of preservation, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Ummah have managed, walhamdulillah, to keep the Quran exactly how it was from the day it was revealed until today. So from the time in which it was revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the angel Jibreel to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is exactly the same way that we recite it today. And this is because of these rigorous methods. It is because when it came to our pious predecessors, mashallah alayhum, they done things properly. Especially when it came to the Qur'an and the Sunnah and religious matters. Now as we all know, the Qur'an is preserved. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Qur'an, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. It was us who revealed this dhikr, who revealed this remembrance. وَإِنَّا this Qur'an, remembrance is referring to the Qur'an. وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. And it will be us, again, who will preserve and protect this book. Allahu Akbar. But not only was it preserved through its memory, but it was preserved with its memory along with its tajweed. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. Ibn Mas'ud, he comments upon this ayah and he says, by he who my soul is in his hands. حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ means that he allows the halal. He forbids the haram and he reads as it was revealed by Allah. I repeat, he reads as it was revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is this not direct enough for us? Here comes some more. Direct verses from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. Surah Muzzammil, Surah number 73, verse number 4. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Now Ibn Kathir, he comes and he comments upon this within his tafsir and he says, recite slowly, making the letters clear, for this is an assistance for understanding and pondering the meaning of the Qur'an. Allahu Akbar. So we can see here that by reciting the Qur'an with its tajweed, with tartil, we will achieve understanding and the pondering on the meanings of the Qur'an. It is an assistance of understanding and pondering the meaning of the Qur'an. Now in Surah Furqan, verse number 32, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says towards the end of the ayah, وَرَتَّلْنَاهُ تَرْتِيلًا. Ibn Abbas, once again, he mentions, this is talking about making it clear, the speech of Allah, making it clear, making what you are saying clear. Now, there's so much evidence here for tajweed. Too much evidence here to be continuously speaking about how the importance of tajweed and why we must recite the Qur'an with tajweed. Earlier in the surah, in Surah Al-Furqan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse number 30, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّي إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. The Prophet Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, and the Prophet said, oh my Lord, verily my people have deserted this Qur'an. Now of course there's one end of the spectrum whereby people desert the Qur'an by not listening to its rulings, by not pondering upon its meanings, by not implementing it within their lives. And there's the second or another way we can look at it, which is that we're deserting a part of the Qur'an, which is this tajweed. Now we don't even want to be a part of this group. We want to be nowhere near these people whom, as it's described in the ayah, the people who deserted the Qur'an, deserted. We don't want to be a part of these people in any way, shape or form. So when it comes to the Qur'an, let's make sure we take the Qur'an as a complete package. We don't just take its text, but we take its text and we take the way it's meant to be recited. And this is how the Qur'an is to be read. Now lastly, I want to leave you with something which, some words of encouragement of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where we find in Sahih Bukhari, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. So the best among you are those who learn the Qur'an and they teach it to others. So let's try our best here to be amongst the best of people and to teach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's words, to teach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's speech by getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after learning his book, we go ahead and we teach it to others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from these people. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.